these things. That is why unakuta kina Babu Owino wanatoka parliament ati wanaanza kujifanya ati wako na Gen Z. Gen Z oye. Gen Z tunasema serikali iende nyumbani. Babu Owino, the agenda ya Azimio is not the agenda ya Gen Z. That is that is where we draw it. That is where we draw it, because themselves, even as Azimio or as opposition, they have failed us. They have failed us. They have gone to the streets before. They have told us that wandamanaring ndio maisha imlisho chini, but they never did that. Walenye wamemalizika, wenye wamekufa, tunasema pole. Na mimi ningependa sana actually we push for justice of these people.
Hello guys, it's your girl Patience Saitas. Welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time here, make sure you hit the subscription box and put on the notification bell so you know for any time I post a new video. You know I'm the queen of online gossip. So welcome to today's video. Don't forget to like and leave a comment in the comment section.
Kagushia tutamfinya. Kagushia anafaa afinywe kabisa. Kagushia anafaa afinywe kabisa. By the constitution, the president cannot withdraw the finance bill. Yes, he cannot withdraw. He can reject to sign and send it back to government at parliament with recommendations, okay? So he refused to sign it. He sent it back to parliament with the recommendation that they remove it in its entirety. And that is exactly what parliament will do. He's still the same man who mobilized those parliamentarians to vote for it. So he has still mobilized them to remove it. So let us, we cannot again at lose life in the name of we want, because we are saying that it will pass before 21 days. I wish we could wait until we are told, like they have refused to remove it as parliament. But I believe that parliament is, okay, it is in recess. Ona sashida ni, our people are not informed. Parliament is in recess. Parliament has been recalled. It was actually recalled yesterday by the speaker. Just the same way it was recalled the day before, ikakuja kupitisha ile bill ya kuleta KDF kwa street. It is just a matter of recalling it, discussing it, and removing it. And actually, it is dead. It is in the process of being buried. Let us not put emotions, because again, kuna wengine wetu again, we would want to see a fire over fire over fire over fire over fire. I have said it for a fact, and that is true. Yeah? Ikipita 21 days ni law. Yes, so what do you recommend? Do you recommend we start undermanaring Kesho until 21 days, or do we wait for 21 days? Do we? What do you recommend? It is in recess. Recess means that not recee. Ameandika vibaya because he doesn't know. Hizi mambo ya kusoma updates Facebook. Inakoseanga watu. It's good to inform yourself. It's good to inform yourself. So, it has been recalled. They discuss it. They remove it. Fine and good. Mimi ikienda hakuna shida. That is what I wanted actually. Jesuare homa, do we wait for 21 days? Yes, you see things like that. Yeah, we don't again start to sianze kupush for tutakasa sawa jinga. And I know there are people who would want that. There are people who even want Kenya itukwange na maandamano daily. Yani wanatakanga hiyo. Kuna alafu wale watu ije. Unajui maandamano ni ya Gen Z. Most of us have never gone to maandamano. It is actually very recommendable for Gen Z wanafraia sana kuenda kwa street. Kuna wale wengine mbao bado, kuna wale wengine political players who actually fight with the government. Now they recommend, au ndio wale wanarecommend, hey, Ruto must go, tuende tukangoe serikali, sisi hata tuipendi. You know, people are hijacking these things. That is why unakuta kina Babu Owino wanatoka parliament, ati wanaanza kujifanya, ati wako na Gen Z. Gen Z, oye, Gen Z tunasema serikali iende nyumbani. Babu Owino, the agenda ya Azimio is not the agenda ya Gen Z. That is that is where we draw it. That is where we draw it. Because themselves, even as Azimio or as opposition, they have failed us. They have failed us. They have gone to the streets before. They have told us that wandamanaring ndio maisha imlisho chini, but they never did that. Walifichwa bomas, wakapewa kikombe ya chai, wakanyamaza. So they cannot come and start claiming and taking advantage. We cannot accept that. And that is why you see yesterday, the majority of young people knew what they were in the street for. And yesterday, they felt like the finance bill has gone, so they felt that hakuna haja ya kuandamana. You understand? Yeah, because there is no need to lose more life. That was it. There was no need to lose more life. Ati mnatuchocha, chochana. With the reason, and I want to speak about State House. I want to speak about State House. The reason why we had Occupy State House hashtag is because we wanted the bill was to be signed in yesterday. And we said that on Thursday, we will go to State House to watch President Ruto sign our lives into slavery. That is why we went Occupy State House. Now that he refused to sign the bill the day before, the agenda actually ikakuwa thwarted. Now we were wondering, people are still pushing. Tuende State House, tulikuwa tunaenda kufanya nini? Even if we went, we would have lost like 20 people, 30 people. Sini ukweli? Haya, do you think by marching to State House would have changed anything until today? It wouldn't have. Hainge change kitu. Sindio, unaona napigiwa simu. I told you guys I have to go because I have to go to somewhere. Hainge change kitu. Walking to State House doesn't make a president akose kuwa president. Watu wangekufa kama watu 30, watu 40, na hakuna kitu inge change. Finance bill ishakataliwa, that is fine. That is a fact. In as much as wengine wetu tunataka cling on ati, oh, it is not passed until 21 days, no. That, oh, una cling hapo, hapana, vijana wanafaa kuendelea, Zakayo ni mjanja. He's naked. He's totally naked. There is no way he would bring it back. He's an afraid man. He's something else. Yeah. And for the first time, we have seen fruits of maandamano. And I can tell you, for those people who are there, ile siku ya maandamano, it was the biggest in Kenya ever. So they have totally had it. He cannot bring it back. I highly doubt. Na ndio maana unaona they are very fast to recall the parliament because wameona watu wameanza kusema hapana, anaweza kosa 21 days. Amesha recall parliament. The majority leader mwenye alileta, actually the person who can only withdraw the bill is Kimani Ichung'wah. Kimani Ichung'wah is the sponsor of the bill in parliament and is the only person who can withdraw the bill. So what Kimani will do, the parliament has already informed the parliament, the members of president's decision. So what he'll do, he'll call them and then Kimani will propose about the president withdraw. They will look at the reasons and then they will vote to withdraw. Of course, Azimio MPs will vote yes, withdraw the bill. And of course, Kenya Kwanza MPs will vote yes, withdraw the bill. So let us not cling on something for an excuse of putting our young people again on the street. Mungine uliwe, we have lost enough and people should understand that one life is worth it. Is so much worthy. I fight finance bill at I take one life. We should stop the culture of we don't care how many die to the maandamano. We don't care. That is how politicians have been doing it with us. They have been taking us to the streets every day. We go die on the streets. Watu wanazikwa na magunia, wanazikwa hivi in halaiki. They never even achieve the mission ya kwenda maandamano. Tunaandamananga, vijana wa ghetto wanauliwa, vijana wengi wanauliwa, tukisema nani lazima ingie president, nani lazima kuwe hii, but it doesn't do anything. It only amounts as fighting for those politicians. That is what I'm saying. Shirondego, thank you for subscribing. That is what I'm saying. If we have to andamana, yes, it's our right, lakini tukwe tunandamana for a reason, for a cause, and we must agree that this cause touches everybody. Like the finance bill. Very fine, we have gone. Lakini mambo ya kutumua na wanasiasa, tuende kwa barabara, tukapigane, tunashutiwa bure. Now wanasiasa actually are playing us. Wakiekwa chini, wakikaka, tukiandamana miezi mbili, they still pass the finance bill. That means that we don't achieve anything in the maandamano. Over 50 people are dead. Hata hawa wanasiasa, hawafanyangi mchango. Hii maandamano ya Gen Z, watu wamechanga hata kusimamia matanga. Wanasiasa wenyewe wafanyangi hata mchango ya kusimamia mazishi yao vijana. They don't lower the prices of anything. Na hao wanasiasa wakikalishwa kwa viti huko, mnasikia wanakuja, oh, hii kiti inawekwa hivi, hii wanawekwa hivi, unapewa gari tatu, unafanyiwa nini? The politicians tend to be happy. Tend to be happy and tend to benefit from such maandamanos. Izo apana, we will be fighting for a cause, we will be going to the streets for a cause. That is it. Kama saizi mnafaka, if young people today were telling us that we are supposed to recall these MPs because they went against the will of the people. Yes, they're supposed to be representatives of the people, and if they don't represent the people, they should be recalled. If people were pushing for constructions of IBC, tuambie serikali, we are giving you 2 months. Make sure that IBC is reconstructed because hakuna commissioners. Reconstruct IBC for those hiyo time inakuwa in 2 months. We start collecting signatures, recall these MPs. That is a worthy cause. Lakini si ati unatuambia tuandamane for no reason and for no actually no plan. Even if people were, kuna wale walikuwa wana insist sana. Inafaa baka hawa vijana wageuze serikali. Ni sawa. then what would happen after that? Would we make life better or more worse? Let us be honest and think and judge like adults. How would it be? We don't have an IBC already. We would turn this country upside down. And there are people who are adults who would want such things to happen. Yeah, that's why I said there are people who would want to take advantage of such situations. Unaona, in as much as young people who are very mad at the finance bill, it is gone. It is gone. You are telling us 21 days isipokuwa signed itakuwa sheria. Fine and thank you. Ikikuwa sheria, twende nalo. Nobody is saying amesarenda kuandamana, hapana. Lakini tusiamuke, twende tukauliwe bure. Ama one life is worth it. If it was your brother, na mimi nataka niseme, kama ni brother yako, ni sister yako, matanga, ni disco matanga ni tamu ikiwa kwa jirani. When it is in your house, when it is you waking up unapatia majirani chai, brother yako amelala pale, that is when you understand. So let us not be taking life like that. Atuende tu maandamano for no reason, tuende mtu auliwe, mtu apigwe risasi, no need. Kama ni for a reason, for a cause, akina Rex walipass, we made sure that the government has wameshuka, there is no finance bill. We are asking for liability. Kama tunakuwa tuna push that the police will take liability eyes of vifo, they should be pushed. I power wa make sure na kama wasipo make tunafuata tuwafurushe, because you have been shown there is a lot of power in numbers. Now those are worthy causes. We fight for the rights of those ones who are killed. Lakini not we go to look for more deaths for no reason. Hata tukienda kwa Zakayo, natuache kufikiria, tuache kumibangwa na wanasiasa. Hata tukienda state house Zakayo, tunatua Zakayo president. Hapana. He would still take a chopper and he would still be the president. He would still go to Kisumu and be the president. He can even go to the US and he would still be the president. So we'll have achieved nothing and lost a lot of life for no reason. Sindio? For no reason. So wanyame malizika, wanyame kufa, tunasema pole. Na mimi ningependa sana, actually we push for justice of these people. These people should not have died. They cannot die in vain. A young girl, Gedurai, mama kwa kibanda, they should not do that. No, they should be taking responsibility. Now those are worthy causes. Lakini simu tuambie tuamke tuanze kutembea maandamano tukienda nini, hapana. Don't misdirect young people. And mimi I like the way young people are very clever. Very very clever. I saw some politicians. Babu nilimuona akiwa Githurai akiambia watu wa Githurai kesho state house kesho. Babu, why are you telling? Walikuwa wanaambia aende state house kufanya nini? You see how politicians take advantage. Babu is not akuitana maandamano ya Gen Z wakiwa na kina Amos Mwango. It is good you voted no, but don't take advantage of these things. Yeah, kuambia watu hapana hapana hapana, just stop it. Yeah, so guys, ladies and gentlemen, Mungu awabariki na awaonekanie. Mimi nasema hivi, for now I don't see the reason kwenda maandamano kwangu, lakini si kwa mtu yeyote. Kila mtu nawaambianga here we are liberal thinkers, independent thinkers. Kila mtu afikiria kwake, fikiria kwako, mimi nafikiria kwangu. Whatever you decide, it's all about you. Whatever I decide, it's all about me. Okay everybody, sasa you are addressing Marcos. Yes, on my platform, what will you do about it? Marcos, what will you do about it? I have to tell them the truth. Yes, we will not let politicians take advantage of Gen Z's maandamano. It didn't happen. It can't happen. We will go to the streets when we want to go, Marcos. Are you okay? Sawa. Aya, peace please, nimekuwa kwa page yako, nikakuona wewe mpaka ni mama uko majuu, ni mama uko na watoto. Sijaona watoto wako kwa barabara. Yes, it may think it is stupidity, but we never went to serve the interests of people who have other ambitions. Okay? As young people, we refuse. And we have refused. And there is nothing we'll do about it, sorry. Hey, thank you so much. Guys, we always speak the truth. We say that it never goes with well with everybody. Kuna wengine wanaweza ona si vizuri. Sasa wewe pia ni Gen Z. Akina Marco, sawa. Kuna wengine wanaweza ona tujafanya vizuri, sawa. But as we went to fight for the finance bill, we fought it. It is down. We have achieved what we went to do. Thank you very much, okay? Yes. Yes. We know there are people who don't Kenya to be in anarchy. Kuna wale wanaweza taka tuandamane kila siku. Tungoje siku 21 zishe. Ikikuwa kama ni sheria tuende kwa barabara. And we go for one reason. We go to reject the finance bill. We go to stop punitive laws. We make Kenya a better country. That is all about young people. We want to make Kenya a better country. Regardless of how much you hate this one or this one. Even if today Raila Amolo Odinga was to be the president, the young people would still unite against him if he brought such punitive laws. That is it. We want a better country. We actually don't even want leadership. We actually don't want, we just want a better country for all of us. Are we together? Haya. Tuko pamoja though. You've all done us. Everyone is jumping on the Gen Z wagon. Your voice, you've done us proud. Thank you. And actually, it's not about the Gen Zs alone. We hate the millennials. Personally, I'm not. I'm 1 year older than a Gen Z, the oldest Gen Z. Because the oldest Gen Z now is 27 years old. I'm 28. People like Koyar over 30. Koyar anatoka kukua youth. Maybe in youth. Ni senior youth. So, unaona, people went out to fight for their country in their numbers. Those people who died, kuna wale mbaka si Gen Z, and they fought, and some of them died. And guys, ebu tukutane, wacheni miende kazi. Naenda mahali, tukutane badaye, jioni, tukule mshene. I have a question, ask. Kyo yuliza, haya, Kyo is here. Ask a question there, ulizia hapo. Kyo, bye. Nenda job, ndio napigiwa simu 10.
So thank you so much guys for viewing this video. Thank you for watching to the end. Make sure you like, share, comment, subscribe, and put on the notification bell so you're not spending time I post a new video. Thank you so much, and I'm gonna see you on my next video. Goodbye.